technologies are at a place where they can be used as a tool. A tool where volunteer organizations and groups and people can find those who need help and go to them instantly, whether or not you're with an organization or not, and rescue them and bring them out. As it's portrayed in the media or by politicians, may look like one Cajun in a boat, as Noah, but as a movement, it's not. This movement is huge, and behind the scenes, we have hundreds and hundreds of people who can volunteer because of technology across the country and across the world by doing crowdsourcing, by using social media. And actually, most of the leaders of these volunteer rescue groups are not your traditional outdoorsmen. They are people with marketing skills. They are people who are really good at social media. They are computer developers, like Crowdsource Rescue, which was two computer programmers who had never done anything in disaster before that built a Uber-like rescue app during Harvey that's continued on now for other disasters. What does this mean for emergency management moving forward? How will we use this tool to provide needs for communities? My other research on social media and Twitter shows that Twitter is more often used in disasters in higher income white neighborhoods that probably don't need rescue help. So are we missing out the people who really need rescue support by relying on social media? Are we also encouraging people who want just fame, who want to run to the most harrowing rescue and do Facebook Live or live tweet their rescue app, and then potentially get hurt in the process? Because volunteer rescuers lost their lives in Harvey because they went into areas that were too dangerous for what they could handle with their boating skill sets. Or will we use this tool to promote altruism in disasters and promote a real movement that addresses the large needs of climate change, the large needs of increasing hazardous risk, and increasing flooding across all of our different communities?